So we're out at a former mine site called Jumna Mine, west of Herbertum, on the Atherton Tablelands in far north Queensland. Our job today for our client is to deliver an aerial image and a digital terrain model of this site to assist in planning the remediation of the tailings dams on this mine. So for a quick overview of what we're planning to do today, we're going to establish our base station over a benchmark and continue to collect RINEX logs. We're then going to go out and paint a network of ground control and quality checkpoints across the site, conduct our drone operation to acquire LiDAR and aerial imagery data, come back out and map those painted marks on the ground and collect all that information and take it back to the office for post-processing. On site today, as you can see, we've established a benchmark. In fact, we found an existing benchmark that we've sort of remediated and installed an additional witness post for, to both protect the benchmark and to make it easier to identify for future surveys. So you can see that we've established a second benchmark here today for continued quality assurance to set up our rover on top of, and just to confirm that we are observing the expected coordinates for this point. We do this occupation at the beginning and at the end of each day as part of our quality management process. In terms of the tasks for today, prior to coming out on site, we've had to do a little bit of mission planning, and that has involved taking into account that area of interest and thinking about the control points that we need to establish in the landscape to coordinate our data and to ensure that it aligns with real world coordinate systems. So today, on top of establishing a benchmark for our future surveys to ensure that they all tie in, we're also establishing a network of ground control points and quality checkpoints across the site. So this is one of our ground control points, and as you can see, we've used a template to lay down a white and black diamond cross. The ground control points are used during the processing of the data, and once the data has been processed, the quality checkpoints come into play. They are used to evaluate the three-dimensional coordinates of the digital data set and to compare those to the known three-dimensional control points, the quality checkpoints that we acquire today. And then we document the variance in those and report on that as part of our data deliverables and report deliverables for the customer.
From the camera view, three times the switch, we activate the compass calibration.
This is necessary on the first flight on every different area.
Today we'll be doing a flight with terrain follow. So there's an elevation module that was uploaded into the controller, and the drone is supposed to follow that module. It helps in collecting better data, especially for LiDAR. We'll be flying at 60 meters high from that model at 4.7 meters per second, because we are also collecting RGB data together with LiDAR data.
So we've established our GNSS rover over the top of this quality checkpoint. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is to go into my Emlid ReachView app and create a name for this point that is unique and relevant to this point. I'm going to double check that my pole height is correct. So it's a 2 meter pole, and I'm making an allowance for an additional 40 mils for the quick release adapter that's at the top of my pole. If you're using those, it's pretty easy to forget that extra 40 mils, so make sure you remember it. I've selected my reach view only to collect points when I have a GNSS fix. We've got a really solid fix here. There's no problems with that whatsoever. And I've set the averaging time for 40 seconds, which is actually pretty long. The benefit of going for a longer observation is that if you have a bit of a hostile environment for GNSS, like overhanging vegetation, it allows you to get a really good sample size. So we're sampling at 5 times a second. So over 40 seconds, we're going to have 200 samples of this position. And what we can see is the residuals, and we can see the RMS values change. And if they start to grow really quickly, then we know that we've got a problem with the selection of this site. If you're only occupying the site for 5-10 seconds, you don't really have a lot of data to be able to compare and to determine that you have got a good site or not. So it's all looking pretty good. I'm going to hit measure on my app, and it's going to automatically time down that 40 seconds and accept the point at the end of that 40 seconds. If for any reason I get sick of waiting, I can always hit the accept button in the app and collect that point even quicker. Things are looking pretty good. Eastings and Northings RMS values are sitting on 10 mil, which is the lowest they ever get. And our elevation RMS has grown to 11 millimeters, which is still really fabulous. Very happy with the selection of this site. So even with a little bit of overhanging vegetation in the view of this receiver, we're not having the quality of our positioning impacted. That's it, 40 seconds done and dusted. Time to go to the next control point. So today we've come to this abandoned mine site. We've established a couple of benchmarks. We've laid out a network of ground control and quality control points. And we've flown our 5 drone missions to collect RGB imagery and LiDAR data. We've also mapped in those quality control and ground control points. And we're going to take all of that data back to the office and post-process it to deliver correct geo-referenced ground control and quality control points that we can use in conjunction with the RGB and LiDAR data in DJI's Terra software. At the conclusion of that post-processing workflow, we will have delivered a geo-referenced colorized LiDAR point cloud and ortho image for this site. That information can then get taken into third-party processing softwares, which we can use to deliver the data sets that the customer has asked for here today. So thanks very much for joining us. I hope you've enjoyed today's video. If you like it, please feel free to give us a like below, and we'd love to hear from you. Please feel free to leave a comment. Please feel free to subscribe to our video channel, and we hope to see you next time.